Hey YouTube, and welcome to my 7th tutorial video. Today I'll be covering miscellaneous tools, additionally with the curve editor. That's going to be an interesting one. First of all, what I would like to talk about is the right click command, or the right click in the drawing area. So once I right click within this area, it's going to open up obviously this right click menu to select all input assets, the stage, sequence the stage, and show all. But if I want to select escape, it's not going to escape from this, and I can't actually right click out of it as well. So you have to left click to actually remove that. Additionally, on the right click option there, if you hold it in, you can pan within your drawing area. Okay, so first of all, I think I've mentioned this before, that you can actually change your frames per second. Now I think that if you make this 40, it will be 40 frames in 1 second. I'll stick to my normal 20 frames per second. Additionally, what you can do is change the speed of your animation playback. Just looking at that, you can see it increases according to that time of multiplier itself. Now, other tools include, obviously, copying these animation keyframes out. So if I press Control C, Control V, we'll paste that in. And I think that is also found within this toolbar here. The first one is copy keyframe, second one is cut keyframe, and then paste keyframe. And in the back, it's got the shortcut key, which is Control C, Control X, Control V. Another one there is obviously as well the delete keyframe, which is controlled by backspace of delete. And we've also got a repeat animation, which will loop this indefinitely when you play the animation. Obviously, if it's off, it's just going to stop by the 40th frame. Another thing to talk about there is the onion layer, which I like a lot. I haven't used it too much before, but once I switch that on, you can actually see it sort of shows you where your animation is going to go towards with blue. Obviously, the red ones will be from where it was. Just looking at this, if I move my cursor along the way, just selecting that, you can see it sort of plays through that animation. And the onion is controlled by this add-on slider. So if I just drag that out, it will contain all of my frames, 40 frames in total. Moving this out will pan it around. I can use the red one as well, just to go a little bit back, to see all of my animation sequences. I'm just going to switch that off. Because the next thing I'm going to talk about is just quickly about the timeline here. Noticing at the bottom right, you have this paste fit option, which will fit your animations in the view there. Additionally, you can scroll on the slider to increase or decrease the size. But you can also hold your mouse over this dark area to zoom it in and out, to actually enlarge or decrease that size. Another thing there is you can select all of these various frames, holding the control key, you can see selects the various keyframes. Well, let me just try it again. Oops. And then when I move one of those, it moves the rest of them. Additionally, what you could have done, which is much easier, is simply holding the control key and just holding your left key and dragging out to select make a selection window, which will select all the frames within that region. You can also hold your control key on these individual bones. And just holding control key and selecting them and selecting my roots, body and torso, you can see move those individually in your timeline. We also have these keys, like for instance move right, you've got a bone selector or a keyframe. If I move that right, you can see it moves out the 20th keyframe as well as the 40th, so it keeps it in 20 frames on that part. If you select obviously the first one, it will move all three of them out. Now there's another key there, which is the adjust one, which I do not, I haven't seen the benefit of it or the use of it. Maybe someone else can explain to me in the comments what that actually does. Then the next important thing is starting with the curve editor. Now I'm just going to start off quickly there on one of the bones, like for instance the body. As soon as you select that, notice that on your properties panel, you'll have your tweening option there, which is either align or none. Obviously, if you set to none, you will have no, say there's no tweening from frame 0 to 20, and it just jumps immediately between frames. So if it's set to line, it will obviously add in the images in between those frames. There was another tool that you guys probably saw, was the rotate function. Now on auto, it doesn't, it's up to you to rotate the animations, but if you change it to CW, not exactly sure what that stands for, you can actually see it rotates this animation out to the, just check that, to the right. If I change it to CCW, it rotates it to the opposite side, so it automatically rotates that bone around its axis. Now, the one I want to talk about is your curve editor. If you have multiple bones selected and you start the curve editor command, it will adjust the curves for all four of those, or the one selected. If you only have one selected, like for instance the body, and you apply a curve, looking at this, you have the options for none, linear, base in, base out, and base both. Additionally, you have the copy and paste, so you can copy these curves through the various bone structures. So obviously none we've done before, so it just removes the tween. Linear is just a normal transition, and then we get to base in. If we look at this curve editor box here, I'm just going to quickly dock it next to my property. Just expand it a little bit. Notice that this length here, or along the axis, or the x-axis, will be the time in your animation. And the percentage use, or the percentage views here, is obviously the percentage of the animation playing, or the movement passed through time. So if it's low like this, looking at the animation, first starting with linear, oof, I gotta switch that rotation off. Let me just check that quickly on the property, auto, curve editor, and then plane. We can see it's just a linear movement. As soon as you place this on something else, like for instance, let me just stop that and play a little bit quicker. 0.5 should be fine. And I make this base in. Notice that it's going to start progressively slower, and then it's going to move out towards the end. Something a bit more drastic will actually show that. Base out is just the opposite. Starts faster, ends slower. Base both obviously starts slow, medium is normal, and then it ends faster, or slower, sorry. Now if we look at the linear one, and I move my cursor towards that line, you'll notice it creates that little square, which means I can actually select that, click on that, and it'll add edit point. So if I move that down, noticing from the timeline in that x direction, it will be the total time in animation, and the percentage will be total animation. So if I place that down, notice it starts slow and ends fast. It's a peak at the end. The other side starts quick, ends slow. Now, like an interesting one is, using these grip points on this line here for the curve editor, I can actually rotate that, drag that out, and this is probably the best part of the animation of this curve editor. Noticing that you can double back on a specific part. So just starting here from zero, it goes up to the peak at 100% on that time, here about 5-6 frames, and then it goes back to the start on the 12th, 13th frame. So it's like a double animation in one of these. Additionally, like I said, you can copy this out, copy this one out, select the next bone, and just paste it in there. And then we have those curves pasted to both of my animation sequences from 0 to 20, 20 to 40. Definitely worthwhile to play around with the curve editor. I think it will greatly improve your animations. So if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe.